Welcome to Stranger Than Fiction, the new TV show, or YouTube show, from SRTV with tons of flair, Eon. We couldn't make up this news if we tried. Tonight we'll discuss animals, how they can screw you over, video game companies too. I'm your host, Kieran Sullivan. Thanks for tuning in. Let's get weird. There was a man bit by a rattlesnake the other day. Victor Pratt of Arizona decided to do what all people do when they encounter a snake. He wanted to barbecue it, because it tastes like chicken. So, much to his avail, he actually did catch the rattlesnake, so hats off to him. Unfortunately, it also bit him twice. When he picked it up, he decided to do what everyone does, take a selfie with it. After playing around with it for a few minutes, it ended up biting him in the head and the chest. Now, he was rushed to the hospital, and he did pull through, but I think he learned his lesson. Just because there's a snake, you really shouldn't do it for the vine, especially no matter how good it tastes. Now let's get down to some monkey business, and of course PETA is involved with this, that joker of a company. David Slater, animal photographer, 2 years ago took a very infamous photo, not because it was bad, but because of the area surrounding it. David guided some monkeys into taking some photos with his camera. 2 years ago, he published those photos on many different websites, and when it ended up on Wikipedia, they eventually said that the monkey owned copyright because David tried to take it down, and they used that as their defense to keep it up. Now PETA jumped right on that bandwagon and saying, yes, that monkey owns the copyright to that photo. Now 2 years of litigation later, David still can't get off the hook for this photo. He's doing everything he can, but he has to pay his bills, and he just can't because of all the lawyers he needs to defend against Naruto the monkey, who PETA has assured everyone is the monkey that was photographed. But with David's defense saying that it wasn't the monkey, it's really a whole gray zone. So David has decided there's no joy in photography anymore if things like this are gonna happen with companies claiming rights to his photographs. So now he's decided to become something greater than he was before. And now for our third topic, Epic Games has released a new game, Fortnite, which is a lovely multiplayer game, except something weird happened. Crossplay was enabled between the Xbox and PS4. Now this was unintended. And in the beginning, people were a bit confused because, like, that guy's username isn't possible. How is this happening? And then finally, someone did some research and found out that, yes, crossplay was enabled between PS4 and Xbox One. And as we all know, Sony does not like cooperating with other companies when it comes to crossplay, with the exception of Minecraft in the near future. So they took it down, and Epic released a statement saying this was actually a bug. What happened was they had crossplay turned off in the files for the game, but on release, it was actually turned on. So they released an apology, in a sense, which would essentially be like if Cinnamon Toast Crunch accidentally released a batch of cereal that cured all diseases, and was like, oh, whoops, sorry, there was a problem with our sugar machine, we fixed it now. And you know, this was a great step for the future, people thought, but it turns out to be a whole mistake that really just gave us a glimpse into what could be, but never was. Anyway, on that note, that's enough for now. Remember, if you're in Russia, don't go emo. They consider it a threat to national security. As again, I'm Kieran Sullivan. Thank you for tuning in, and get hyped for the next episode of Stranger Than Fiction.